Hallelujah. Praise the living God for a wonderful new month once again. We are in the month of October and God has been so faithful. We are gradually gravitating towards the end of the year, and it is by the grace and the mercies of God. So we thank God, and I've tagged this month the month of divine progress. Divinely, we ought to progress after all these times of lockdown, after all these times of coronavirus pandemic, staying in the house. I believe that this is the month that we need to spring forth and progress and advance into our destinies in the name of the Lord Jesus. Here in South Africa, we are actually in the month of the spring. We are in the spring. It means that crops will now start growing. It means that plants that will now start, we will be seeing green from this month going. And I believe that as we have also entered into this new month, God is going to advance our life and all things will work together for our good in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. My name is Magdodu, President of Voice of Dominion Outreach. If you have not subscribed, you can subscribe it down there. You can also share it and like it, and let your friends and your family members always come together with us, and let us encourage each other. Let us pray together. Let us inspire each other. And I believe that your life will never be the same after this session in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this new month, month of October, the 10th month, which is divine progress. We thank you, O God, and we know that everything that is in October, anything blissful that is in October, will be our portion in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I greet you all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And as I said earlier on, it is the month of divine progress. When we say something is progressing, that means that thing is advancing. That thing is increasing. That thing is profiting. It is increasing and there is a breakthrough. That is progress. And this month, divinely, we are progressing in every aspect of our life. When we say something is divine, that means that thing is, it's like God. When we say divine, divine is God. When we say divine, we mean that that thing delightfully, or it is going to move pleasantly in everything that you do. So I want to admonish you and I encourage you that all the things that may have happened during the course of the year, this month is the month of advancement. It is the month that you're going to see a turnaround. It is the month that you will see progress in everything that you do in the name of the Lord Jesus. You see progress in your finances. You see progress in every aspect of your life, at your workplace. You see progress in your business. You see progress in your Christian life. There must be progress in your prayer life. There must be progress in your spiritual life. There must be progress in everything that you do. There must be an advancement. You don't need to be stagnant in whatever you are or wherever you are, but you need to get up your loins and move forward and charge forward, because it is the month of divine progress in your life. And so I want you to grab this month holistically and move towards a great destiny in your life. Move towards whatever that you have lost previously and let you advance and grab whatever that really belongs to you in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. The Bible said in Isaiah chapter 61 verse 1, and Isaiah says something, and it was the same thing that Jesus also said in Luke chapter 4 verse 18. So let us read Isaiah chapter 61 verse 1, and I want us to read from the New International Version, and then let us read. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted. He has to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners. And that was the same thing that Jesus said when he went to Nazareth, his hometown, after going all over the world, preaching the gospel, healing the sick. He came back to his own. He came back to his own, if it is this day, we'll say his own country. And in the synagogue, he took this scroll that was written by Isaiah, and he read it in Luke chapter 4 verse 18. He also said that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. So I came to announce to you that this month that we are in, this new month,
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and He has anointed me to preach the good news to you. He is telling you that if you are poor, there is good news coming. There is a sound of an abundant rain that is coming in your life. This month, poverty will never be your portion anymore. So it is a good news I am preaching to you today, that Lord, the Lord is taking you away from your poverty, from your poor state. The good news is that He has made all things beautiful in His time, and this is the time that you'll be liberated from any poverty in the name of the Lord Jesus. The good news is that if you want to see financial breakthrough, you need to give this month. Be generous in this month. First of all, pay your tithe, because your tithe will open greater doors for you. Bring your first fruit to the Lord. Secondly, be generous. Give alms. Give it. The Bible says that give and it shall be given unto you. Pressed down, running over, shaking together. And that's the good news I have for you this month. And when you become generous, you know, in this our world, we say that 1 + 1 = 2. But it, divinely speaking, when you give the one away, that is when you will get more. It was not a mistake when the Bible said the other day that when Jesus was preaching, there was a lot of people that followed Him. And when He went to the desert, or He went to a place where there was no food, He asked the disciples that get them something to eat, because these people are very hungry. And there were about 5,000 people, and you can imagine 5,000 men. We have not counted women. We have not counted children. But they said 5,000 men. And how do you feed 5,000 men when there's no food? But the Bible says that there was a young boy who said that I've got what? I've got 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes here. He gave it away, and the Bible said that when he gave it away, it was like a seed, it was like a giving, it was like what? Giving out what you have, and there was an abundance in the life of all the people and that guy or that boy. Imagine, the Bible says that he took the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fishes, he blessed it and he gave it. And the Bible said that they ate, the 5,000 men, they ate, the people that were over 5,000, they ate, and there were 12 baskets full of leftovers. Imagine, just 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. That's the good news to you. If the boy had kept his 2 fishes and the 5 loaves of bread, do you think that he would have had an abundance? He never kept it. I'm imagining that that was like his lunch. Maybe the mom just prepared lunch for him. That, you know what, this is your lunch. As you follow Christ, you will eat that one. But I am very much sure that he never believed that that 2 fishes and that 5 loaves of bread, he could get a lot more with that 2 fishes and that 5 loaves of bread. That is the good news I'm preaching unto you, that as you give unto the Lord this month, there will be a breakthrough, there will be an advancement, there will be an increase, there will be a profit in whatever that you have. Because after that miracle, I believe that now the child now has a lot of food now to eat, even for the family, even to take some of them back home if he wants to. Because he what he had, he gave it out. So this is the Bible says that he has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. So if you are poor, I am preaching this good news. If it is financial poverty, I believe you, me, and I want to tell you that be like that boy. If you give it away, there will be an increase, there will be an overflow in your life. And that is the good news I am speaking to you today. Poverty is not only about food. Poverty is not only about money. You can also be poor in your society. You can be poor knowledge-wise. You can be poor wisdom-wise. You can be poor even in your workplace. You can be poor. Yes, you can have a lot of money. You may be paid a lot of salary, maybe a lot of money. And some people may be paid a little money, but you are not able to take care of yourself even with that lot of money. Someone may have a little money, just a few bucks, but that money can take him through the whole of the month. But ask yourself, what is it that is preventing you that on the 5th day of the month, your money is finished, you start struggling? This month, may you open up your hands. First, pay your tithe. 2, be generous, give, sow a seed. sow a seed, and when you sow a seed, you will reap. Because if you eat your seed, there's no way that the seed can ever germinate. But when you put the seed on the ground, it will grow and it will germinate. So, beloved, we have started this series this month, the month of divine progress. We will talk a lot about divine progress till the month ends. Because the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor. We are talking about the good news to the poor. He said, He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to heal the brokenhearted. We will talk about the healing of the brokenhearted next week. And He said that He has proclaimed freedom for the captives. He has released from darkness for the prisoners. So this is one section of divine progress. And I know that next week we will meet again. The Bible says, and I am praying for you. I want you to decree and declare this thing. That I pray that I will prevail over every stagnation in my life. Because the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 4 verse 18. The path of the righteous is like the first gleam of dawn. Shining ever brighter till the fall or to the full light of day. That is the path of the righteous. So I pray that, oh God, may you be released. May you prevail over every stagnation in your life in this month of divine progress. May God release every stagnation from your life. And may there be a progress in your life this month. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Let us pray this prayer right now. That may I prevail over every stagnation in my life. Let us pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, every stagnation in my life, every stagnation in my finances, every stagnation knowledge-wise. For the Bible says that lack of knowledge, oh God. The Bible says that because of lack of knowledge, my people perish. So you may not perish because of lack of knowledge, but you will progress. If you lack knowledge, you are poor. Poverty can also be classified as lack of knowledge. If you don't know anything, you are also poor. So we will continue next month. We will continue next week, I mean. So let us pray that, oh, every stagnation in my life, may it be cleared out in the name of Jesus. Let us pray. Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus, I pray and commit myself unto you, that every stagnation in my life, right from this day, may I progress, may I advance. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I am praying for you. You are liberated. You are anointed. You will never lack from this day. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Thank you for tuning in to Dominion Outreach TV. You can subscribe. You can like it. You can go to our Facebook page, Voice of Dominion. Go and like it and share it with your friends. From Mondays to Fridays, we are always posting devotional messages there. You can do devotions with us. And God will richly bless you. I love you, and I know you love me too. If you have any prayer request, or any prayer request, I mean, you can leave it at the comment section, or you can inbox me, MacDodo, on Facebook. And me and my team will pray with you. I love you, and I know you love me too. Thank you so much. Meet you next week with a continuation of Divine Progress. Bye-bye.